lay in bed and pour a drink of me. And let your friends think you're developing. Hi everyone, welcome to yet another amazing time with me. My name is Chacha Wabara, and on this channel what we do are film reviews. Today we'll be reviewing the Korean Netflix drama known as Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha. Hey, people have finished my name. Now this drama has 16 episodes. It was said to be the next best thing after Squid Game. Okay, so let's head into the highlights of the drama. Okay, I'll see you on the other side, right?
You keep it in a bottle, lie in bed and pour a drink of me. And let your friends think you're developing a problem, but we're happier than they could be.
Welcome to yet another amazing time with me. If this is your first time here and you haven't subscribed, do hit on the subscribe button, turn off your post notifications to be alerted when new videos come up, because you should be expecting new videos from me. Okay, so this drama, Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha, as like I said, is a Korean drama featuring actors and actresses like, hold up, wait a minute, Shin Min-ha, Kim So-ho, Lee Sang-yi, Gong Min-young, Yong-hong, Cho-Han-Cheul, Him Dong-ji, and Lee Bong-hoon. I'm so sorry. So this drama is a laid-back drama. I kind of think that the reason people said this was the next best thing after Squid Game was that, you know how Squid Game took you so high and really want to de-stress, you really want to like detoxing yourself when you're addicted to something, you're trying to detox yourself. I think this drama is to help you detox from that paranoia, that excitement, that thing, that suspense built around your neck after seeing Squid Game. Hometown Chachacha is a Korean drama that is slow. It has to do with this dentist, high-end dentist, that had issues in town and decides to relocate to Gongjin town. And she comes to Gongjin town and she sees that life is different from her, you know, town perspective of life, way of dressing and everything, you know, way of interacting. Like in town, in Seoul, you are allowed to be impersonal, but here everyone is, you know, all up in your business. And then she meets this busybody guy who is everything and has certifications in everything, and he's just a simple guy. And you know, along the line, after the initial irritation and fight, they both discover that they love each other and the relationship builds. Now, there are other characters in this movie. You will not say this is the man-female lead or the male-male lead. Well, they were, but other actors and actresses were given adequate screen time, yeah? And you get to follow their stories. Like, we have the divorced couple and their son. And if you follow that story, it was really like, you know, the man never knew why his wife asked for a divorce. Until after so many years, he now discovered that, you know, she heard him when he was telling someone else that he never loved her and blah, 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 blah. He realized that it was just guys talking. A guy that didn't want to show that he was really into his wife. You know how guys talk. And so she heard it, and when he got back home, she just divorced him based on that he left his socks on the floor instead of in the laundry basket. And so the whole town kept on wondering why this couple got divorced, and they never knew until that issue was resolved. Hi people, I'm back again with Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha. This drama, I have reviewed it. It has taken me a whole of 2 weeks to complete the review. We also have this couple that manage all-purpose grocery store, and they were having their second baby. The wife was feeling neglected when she was pregnant with her baby, and her husband was taking her for granted. It showed how they were able to patch up after, you know, they saw that it was just a misunderstanding of each other's actions. Moving further, we also have a lady that has this food shop, and she outwardly looked really friendly. She was like the town gossip. But a deeper look at her life showed how she lost her only child to cancer, and she was just trying to make ends meet. And then we see a washed up musician with his daughter and his struggles. No one was interested in his music, and he was just managing himself along with so many regrets, and his one daughter he loved to a fault. You know, that's the thing about Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha in comparison to Squid Game, in comparison to Hellbound. It has a way, it's a melodrama, it has a way of, you know, lessening all the tension, reducing all the tension, and it's an everyday drama. I wouldn't say it's boring, but if you're looking for something to, you know, to heighten your senses and all that, then Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha is not for you at all. It's a slow-moving drama that is beautiful to see, with amazing actors and actresses. I actually cried when the old lady died. I wasn't expecting it, and you wouldn't even expect it, because of course there are so many old ladies. So I won't tell you who died. This movie ended beautifully well. After the torment, you will see why the all-purpose guy, you know, the guy that was into everything, you will see why he stayed in the Gongjin town, why he did not venture out of the town. You will see his pain because he lost someone and he blamed himself. You will see everything that transpired. This is a drama story to see, which brings me to the end of this drama review. Up there, you will see my Korean movie reviews, my Chinese movie reviews, my Nigerian movie reviews, and then again my movie reviews. Thank you so much for watching. If you've seen this drama, please leave a comment down below, yeah? And if you haven't subscribed, please hit on the subscribe button to turn up your post notifications to be alerted when new videos come up, because you bet there will be more videos coming up. Thank you so much for watching. Like I said, yeah, did I rate it? Okay, I'll be rating it an 8 over 10. Oh my gosh. I'll be rating this drama an 8 over 10. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.